Hello and welcome. My name is Marissa Reckman, CEO at Agate Labs. We are one of the founding partners of the Agate Foundation, and today we are very pleased to be joined today by some very notable and reputable individuals from the Peter Lougheed Hospital. The Agate Foundation is here today to announce an exciting donation that we pulled together with the Ranson Marilyn Fisher Foundation. This donation is going to be focused in the area of breast cancer surgery, and we're going to talk about how this will improve women's health moving forward. So I'd like to welcome you all here today with me. So we've got Kathy Howe, who is the Executive Director of Surgical Services, Women's Health, Pediatrics, and the NICU, which is quite a mouthful. Kathy, you've got quite a loaded plate, but welcome today.
Thank you. Thanks very much for having me.
You're welcome. And Dr. Jeannie Kaneshiro, who is a breast surgeon in general surgery at the Peter Lougheed. Welcome, Dr. Jeannie. This isn't the first time that you've been here, but welcome again to the Agate Foundation.
Very honored to be here.
And we also are here with Dr. John Hine, who is Chief of Surgery at the Peter Lougheed. Welcome, Dr. Hine.
Thank you for having all this. It's a real privilege to be here.
Yes, you bet. It's always amazing to me that we can get many of you together, given the roles and the responsibilities that you have on a daily basis. So we are very pleased to have each of you here today. So today's donation, again, it's a partnership between the Agate Foundation and the Ranse and Marilyn Fisher Foundation. We've come together. One of the focuses of the Agate Foundation is really in trying to drive initiatives in our communities that help to support the challenges that we face, but through science, research, innovation, and technology. And one of the things that we realize on a global scale is that we have so much access to this new technology, but we don't always have that access directly at our fingertips. And that might be a limitation in funding, limitation in resources. There's many different reasons that go into it, right? But that really is one of the focuses, is being able to kind of look across the world's community and take a look at what is available and bring that to the local communities here in Calgary, Alberta, and certainly across Canada. So this represents one of those moments where the Agate Foundation and Ranson Marilyn Fisher, we were notified that right now there is a bit of a limitation in the resources available when it comes to breast cancer surgery at some of the hospitals here in Calgary. We want to thank you, Kathy, Dr. Jeannie, Dr. John, for making this such an easy transition to be able to get this taken from an idea to implementation. The funding that we're talking about here today, it's a $600,000 donation between the two foundations. Peter Lougheed will be a recipient for some of this funding, as well as the Rocky View. And what this will be funding is the purchasing and procurement of a Flexitron and MagSeed for better, more precise, targeted, and localized surgery when it comes to breast cancer treatment. Now, I am no expert in this field. Of course, you each know so much more in this regard. So I'm going to turn it over to you to talk about why this donation will be so impactful and so important to the Calgary community and to the patients that you see. So Dr. Jeannie, do you want to give us a few thoughts on that?
Thank you, Marissa. It's a real amazing moment for the Peter Lougheed and for the Rocky View that the Agate Foundation and the Ranse and Marilyn Fisher Foundation has come forward with this really generous donation to something that's so important for breast cancer surgery. There is immense change happening, and there's new technology that will make the breast cancer surgery and treatment journey for women so much better. And we've been advocating for a new method to localize tiny tumors for women in a more modern way for a very long time. And it has been a challenge, particularly in our community. Some of the localization methods that need to happen before surgery so that a small tumor can be removed, just so there's enough tissue and to allow the woman to have the best outcome, the best cure, without as much deformity, and has been available and our desire to achieve. But now there is more modern technology that makes it so much more efficient and comfortable, less stressful, and allows for more efficiency and better flow for the patient experience, most of all, and for flow in the surgical access. So that's the part about the Centimag and Mag seed. It's really exciting, a small little magnetic seed that can be placed prior to surgery that's very easy and comfortable for the patient and makes the surgical day more straightforward and less stressful for breast cancer patients. And the second portion of it is a really incredible high-definition X-ray machine that will allow us to visualize the small tumor and the MagSeed marker in the tissue and confirm that everything we need to remove, at least by the imaging, can be ensured that we've done our very best at the time of surgery, and so that we can, with more confidence, say that we have removed all the cancer the day of surgery that we possibly could until we get final results. And that is really helpful to be able to tell a patient right after surgery that, of course, what everyone wants to hear is that we believe that the cancer has been removed to the best of our knowledge. So those two things, the Faxitron and the Centimag MagSeed system, being endorsed and brought to major hospitals in Calgary is just a beginning, I hope. But it's a very huge, generous donation to make this happen, which it wasn't available before. And so I think it's going to make a huge difference to our patients and to the community right here in the Northeast, where Agate lives, and also in the future to the Rocky View community too.
Oh, well, we appreciate you taking us through that. And I know that we've also shot a longer presentation where you go through some of the technical specifications on that as well, too, that will be available to individuals and very thorough in terms of what we're talking about. But, you know, certainly I think from an individual's perspective, as a member of the community, if I unfortunately happened to be a patient, one of the things that's been so fascinating through the journey of the foundation is really learning about, again, some of the limitations that we have that we just don't know about. And we always expect that with a world-class medical system across Canada that we really are getting the best of the best. And we're doing so much positive work across the country, but we can also elevate that even further. And if we can get people understanding and aware of some of these limitations and how they can better affect the outcome and patient health, then maybe we can advocate to have more partners come together on projects like this that will be so meaningful to individuals if we just understand where the needs are and they lie.
If I can add one more thing, I want it to be the beginning. So it's not to limit it to any one part of the city, of course. It's meant to begin something super exciting and to allow for a vision to have this accessible to the whole city, to other parts of the province, because rural centers, smaller centers definitely benefit from this type of endeavor. Yeah. So I just want to say that it's just the beginning, and it's really exciting that Agate Foundation is part of a really exciting beginning.
Thanks. Well, thank you. And I would just like to say that on behalf of the Agate Foundation and the Ranson Marilyn Fisher Foundation, we want to thank each of you for the incredible work that you do. We understand that, you know, without individuals like yourselves being able to do this on a daily basis, patients don't have nearly the opportunity to have their lives saved or improved the way that they would otherwise. We know that it must be very difficult, especially going through the pandemic on top of all of this. And so for each of you to dedicate your lives and careers to something like this, we are incredibly thankful. We wish you nothing but the best. We hope that, like you said, Dr. Jeannie, this is just the beginning, and that moving forward, we continue to help support, along with many others in the community, what you are able to accomplish as individuals and as a team together. So thank you very much for joining us here today.
Thank you.
Okay, and now for the most important part. We've talked about the donation and we've talked about what it will be used for, but I guess you'd like the actual check and the money so we can get this actually proceeding in order. So once again, on behalf of the Agate Foundation and the Ransom Marilyn Fisher Foundation, we are so pleased to be able to pass this over to you. So this will be about the $300,000 portion going to the Peter Lougheed Center for your purchase. So Kathy, I'm going to present this to you.
Thank you very much.
You are
most
welcome.
That's great. Thank you. That's excellent. We're just we're so grateful for this donation and really excited about this equipment and the difference it's going to make in the lives of women and in the lives of others. You know, with that some of the technology, it means that women will only need to go to the operating room once. And now about, you know, 20 to 25 times a year, women have to return to the operating room. When we don't have the Faxitron, we can't see that tumor, we can't see the tissue right at the time of surgery. And so that makes it better for women and for 25 other people who will get to the operating room when women don't have to go twice. So thank you so much for the difference you're going to make. We're so grateful.
Thank you, Kathy.
Thank you.
Dr. Jeannie and Dr. John, any parting words?
Well, just as leaders in the Department of Surgery, Kathy and I are charged with trying to optimize and enhance the delivery of surgical care mm-hmm. to our patients. And as Jeannie started talking to me about this a little bit more, it became obvious to me that the way we're doing it now is cumbersome, inefficient, and probably, frankly, terrifying for a lot of women.
Mm-hmm.
And so when Jeannie started this process moving forward, I became more and more interested in learning about it, and you know, we've really, looking at her passion made me passionate about it as well. And so, absolutely, from my point of view, from Peter Lougheed Hospital, bringing us into the 21st century, this technology is absolutely mind-blowing for us. So again, thank you to the Agate Foundation, to the Ransom Marilyn Fisher Foundation, for your generosity.
Absolutely. Well, that's what it takes, right? A team to be able to get it done from the initial vision all the way to the implementation. So thank you all once again.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
You.